Welcome to Ashland Middle School for Game 10 of the season for Ashland Legion Baseball. 3-6 post 77 today. We'll take on Billerica post 268. Billerica is 1-6 on the season post 77, hoping to stay in playoff contention with a win here today, as getting the start for post 77 on the mound will be Jake Obed, who has had a nice season pitching for Ashland, and he is warming up as we speak. It is a 84 degree afternoon with a slight overcast. The humidity is high. It feels at about 91 degrees. There is questionable weather for later tonight, a chance of a thunderstorm, as we have the first hitter coming to the plate to face Jake Obed. And stepping in first will be Dylan Salk, the second baseman for Billerica. Let's take a look at the Billerica lineup. Second baseman Dylan Salk leading things off. Brendan O'Flaherty, the shortstop, will bat second. Anthony Nelson, the first baseman, will bat third. Justin Burek, the pitcher, will hit cleanup, the windup and the pitch. First pitch is hit, third base side, and it is bobbled. Throw to first, and it is in time. A nice recovery by J.J. Krupe to get the ball across the diamond for the first out. Finishing off the Billerica batting order, David Lindsay, the right fielder, batting fifth. Craig Rich, the third baseman, batting sixth. David Applebaum, the center fielder, batting seventh. Matt Franke, the left fielder, batting eighth. And Jake Nelson, the catcher, batting ninth, as Obed is set to deliver. And this is hit in the air towards left center, and that will drop in front of the reach of Greg Holler for a base hit. Rounding first now, throw to second is not in time. And it is a double for Brendan O'Flaherty, a one-out double that'll bring up Anthony Nelson. Let's take a look at the post-77 field. Jake Obed, the pitcher, his battery mate behind the plate, Nick Porter. Nick Burns over at first, Brendan Wolfe at second base. Mike Messier, the shortstop, J.J. Krupe at third. From left to right, Greg Holler, Brendan Thurber, and Andrew Keim round out the field for Ashland post-77. As Nelson, the first baseman, awaits the pitch. Obed working from the stretch. Runner leading off a second. The leg lift and the pitch is in there for a strike. On camera, it is Connor Donovan. Tom Nappy on the call. You are watching Ashland Legion Baseball on HCAM Television in Hopkinton and WACA-TV in Ashland. A swinging strike. And that makes the count 1-1. Nelson, first pitch was a ball. Obed from the stretch, runner leading off of second. The leg lift and the pitch hit in the air. This is in foul territory to the left side and out of play, 1-2. And there is a good amount of wind today, and it seems to be blowing towards the left side. So that could certainly have a factor in this game as well. The leg lift and the pitch to the lefty. This is hit high in the air, right side. It is in foul territory. And Obed drops it, not able to hold on. Had it in his glove, and it was at the very edge of his glove and just kind of fell out. Count remains 1-2. As Nelson will step back to the plate, Anthony Nelson out of Shawshene Valley Tech will graduate in 2017. Runner leading off of second, Obed delivers. This is hit in the air, left side and in foul territory, out of play. Count remains 1-2 on the righty. See, Nelson likes to pull the ball. Obed takes a look at the runner leading off of second and delivers. Just outside, 2-2. Post 77 getting off a couple road losses last week. They lost to Hudson back on June 30th. And then on July 2nd, a loss to Lowell as this is hit in the air and in foul territory, and it is out of play. Count remains 2-2. Now it's hit over towards us. Obid takes a look at second, set to deliver from the stretch. The leg lift and the pitch. And this is crushed towards left field, towards the wall, and that is off the wall. And it'll drop in front of Haller. The throw in is going to be cut off. No runs will score, and there will be runners on second and third. O'Flaherty moves up to third, Nelson to second. Two on, one out. And now the cleanup hitter, pitcher Justin Burek. And there will be a discussion as head coach of Post 77 will come to the mound to talk to Obid, calm him down a little bit. Ashland, of course, led by head coach Derek Johnson, first year head coach of Post 77, taking over for Dan Sullivan. And a little discussion, some words of wisdom, and we are set once again for baseball. Clouds moving in across the outfield, darkening the field a little bit. We are certainly keeping an eye on the weather this evening. Runners on second and third, one out. Obid from the stretch. He'll step off the mound for quick time and now set to deliver. Takes a look at the runners and deals, and that is a foul. Little tip in front of Nick Porter behind the plate. And one thing I will say about this Ashland team, it has been quite remarkable the versatility they have shown defensively. A lot more on that in just a bit. Nick Porter, one of those guys, as that pitch is down low, who has played a terrific shortstop and, of course, is very solid from behind home plate. The windup and the pitch, and this is hit foul and out of play on to the football field. And this Ashland team, a young team this season. A lot of developing talent. The leg lift and the pitch down low. Obid from the stretch. That one's outside. Looks like we might have someone already getting warm for Ashland, just in case Obid continues to struggle. On the ground, right side, past the dive of Wolf. One run is in, the second run being waved around. The ball just being picked up over in right field, and two runs score. It's a two RBI single for Justin Burek. Brandon O'Flaherty and Anthony Nelson come around to score. And now David Lindsay will step in the left-hander's batter's box. Bill Ricca came with a short roster today, only nine players as his pitch is down low. Bill Ricca, they're certainly desperate for a win after a 1-6 start. They're a young team as well. And this is hit foul. 1-1. Obid from the stretch. That's foul, 1-2. On the ground, up the middle, gloved at short, throw to second for one, throw to first, not in time. So they get one on the play, on the fielder's choice. So Lindsey reaches on the 6-4 fielder's choice. Craig Rich will now come to the plate, the third baseman. Obid working from the stretch once again. There's a strike. Rich also a... That's fouled away. Also out of Shawshin Valley Technical School. Another young player will graduate in 2017. From the stretch, runner leading off of first. Check in, runner slides back just safe. From the stretch, down low. Jake Obid out of Holliston High School. Also will graduate in 2017 as this is up the middle. Glove by the shortstop, and he will step on the second base bag for the third out of the inning. A nice job by Messier, a 6-on-assisted force out, and that will retire the side, but not before Bill Ricca plates 2 runs as we head to the bottom of the first. Bottom of the first inning, a 2-0 lead for Bill Ricca as they plate 2 runs to start things out here at Ashland Middle School. Let's take a look at the post 77 batting order. They are going to go with Brendan Thurber in the leadoff role, the center fielder. Greg Haller, the left fielder, batting second. Nick Porter, the catcher, batting third. Nick Burns, the first baseman, will hit cleanup. Trevor Gustafson, the DH, will hit fifth. Mike Messier, the shortstop, will bat sixth. Andrew Keim, the right fielder, will bat seventh. J.J. Krupe, the third baseman, will bat eighth. And Brendan Wolf, the second baseman, will bat ninth. And they will be facing starting pitcher Justin Burek for Bill Ricca, post 268. Burek is out of Bill Ricca High School, and he will go into his senior year next school year. Let's take a look at the field behind Burek. His battery mate will be Jake Nelson behind the plate, Anthony Nelson over at first base, Dylan Sulk, the second baseman, Brendan O'Flaherty, the shortstop, Craig Rich at third base, Matt Franke, the left fielder, David Applebaum, the center fielder, and David Lindsay, the right fielder for Bill Ricca, post 268. As Thurber will step in after Burek gets his warm-up tosses, and you saw the effect of the wind blowing the balls to the left side in the top half of the first. We'll certainly have to watch out here, as of course we are along the third baseline. Let's recap how Bill Ricca scored the 2 runs on the first inning. Well, they started off with a Dylan Sulk ground out, and then O'Flaherty hit a double as he tattooed the ball, and it dropped in front of the left field fence. We'll have more in just a moment as we are set for baseball, and this is up the third base side and foul by Thurber. Anthony Nelson then hit a single, and that would put runners on second and third. Excuse me, Anthony Nelson hit a double. Brendan O'Flaherty only moved up one base. And then Justin Burek had a 2 RBI single to bring them both in. And then a fielder's choice and a ground out ended the inning. The windup and the pitch is down low. It is a 1-1 count on Thurber as Burek is set to deliver. The leg lift and the pitch, and that is off of Thurber. So Thurber takes one for the team, and will start things off with a post 77 runner on base as Greg Haller will march to the plate. Right off his back, it looked like it went. Fortunately, it seemed like it was a changeup, so not too much velocity. Burek now working from the stretch as the righty Greg Haller awaits the pitch. And he swings for that one, 0-1. Greg Haller with some words for head coach Derek Johnson. And that one is going to get by the catcher, Jake Nelson. And advancing to second base is Brendan Thurber on the wild pitch. As Greg Holler steps back in. Greg Holler, of course, out of Hopkinton High School, graduated this year. Burek from the stretch. That is down low, 2-1. It will be interesting to watch what the Billerica pitching situation will be, as only 9 players available. They might have had a 10th join late, as this is hit foul and out of play. That'll even up the count at 2-2. Burek from the stretch. The leg lift and the pitch. Down low, and that'll get by the catcher. So runner will advance to third, and Thurber will hold up as Nelson does chase it down. That is a second wild pitch by Burek. A full count now on Holler. Burek takes a look at third and deals. And this is up the left side. Slow roller on the grass. Throw to first, and they do get the runner going to first, but the run does score. That was a sacrifice RBI ground out for Holler, and it's 2-1. One out, Nick Porter will come to the plate. Burek set to deliver. Down low, 1-0. Burek to the set. Up the left side and foul, just foul. One and one. Burek to the set. And this is up the left side, and this time it's fair and will get into left field. And that is a single for Nick Porter. Got right between the shortstop and the third baseman. Now we'll bring up Nick Burns. Quite an eventful start to this game so far. Burek deals. There's a strike. Nick Burns has been really one of the key offensive weapons for Post 77 this season, as that one is outside. 1-1. Burek from the stretch. And he crushes this foul to the right side, 1-2. Runner leading off of first, Burek set to deliver. And this is up the right side, foul. One in for Post 77 already. Runner on first, one out. 1-2 on Burns. Burek from the stretch. And he gets a good piece of this. A high fly ball towards right field, and it will be handled by David Lindsay for the out. Second out of the inning, and now Trevor Gustafson will step in. The righty awaits the pitch. Swinging strike. Looks like it grazed the bat as it went into the glove of the catcher. Oh and one as Burek from the stretch. Runner leading off of first, he delivers, and there is strike two. Looks like Gustafson tried to check his swing there. From the stretch. The leg lift and the pitch. And it's strike three, but it gets by. Can he beat it out? And yes, he will. A big break for post 77 as Gustafson reaches on a wild pitch after the strikeout, a pass ball, excuse me. Now we'll bring up Mike Messier. Mike Messier, also out of Hopkinton, was the catcher this season for the Hillers as that one's fouled away. Very good hockey player as well. Graduated this year, will attend Clarkson College next year. Clarkson University, as that one's fouled away, 0-2. Burek awaits the sign and is set to deliver. That one's down low. One and two. Burek from the stretch. And there's strike three. It gets by once again. And the throw to first, not in time. Two straight hitters reach after a strikeout. Bases are now loaded with two outs for Andrew Keim. And now there will be a discussion between the catcher Jake Nelson, Justin Burek, and also the head coach is going to come out. Philip Doran is the head coach today. Dan Goodwin not in attendance for this one. Now he brings the whole infield in. That's the most frustrating thing. Two straight opportunities, you should have been out of the inning. But then the hitters reach on the pass ball. In this inning, there's been two wild pitches and two pass balls. Certainly a bit of a wild bottom of the first. Two wild pitches allowed the run to score earlier as there's a strike. Allowed Thurber to score on the sacrifice ground out by Holler as Thurber was at third after two wild pitches. That one's down low. One and one on Keim. Burek set to deliver. That's down low. That almost got by Nelson as well. It's tough to really gauge. Is it Nelson behind the plate having more struggles or Burek on the mound? Burek awaiting the sign, the leg lift and the pitch. That one's another low one, 3-1. One ball away from a tie game. Leg lift and the pitch. And this is takes a couple hops on the infield grass, glove by the shortstop, flip to second, and you get the out. A big break for Bill Ricca. 6-4 ground out for Keim after two straight hitters reach on pass balls after the strikeout. It's 2-1, Bill Ricca, as we head to the second inning. Top half of the second inning, a 2-1 lead for Bill Ricca. Obit out there for another inning of work. The leg lift and the pitch is down low to David Applebaum, the center fielder. To the set, and he gets a good piece of this one towards center field, but there to make the catch is Brendan Thurber. Looks like Applebaum really reached out to hit that one. That'll bring up Matt Franchi, the left fielder. The windup and the pitch to the lefty. On the ground, up the middle, past the dive of Obid. And it's handled by Messier at short, throw to first, two away. I'll bring up Jake Nelson, the catcher. Quite a slow first inning. It looks like maybe, perhaps, a speedy top of the second. We'll have to wait and see. Of course, anything can happen. Obid awaits the sign, the windup and the pitch to the righty as this is hit in the air, a high fly ball towards right field, and it is handled by Andrew Keim for the third and final out. A well-needed four-pitch inning for Jake Obid, and we will head to the bottom of the second with Bill Ricca on top, 2-1. Set for the bottom half of the second inning. A 2-1 lead for Bill Ricca. Due up for Ashland. The 8, 9, and 1 hitters, J.J. Krupe, Brendan Wolf, and Brandon Thurber. After a wild bottom half of the first, we'll give you the recap in just a moment as Burek is set to deliver. The first pitch is a strike. Thurber started off getting hit by a pitch. Greg Haller then came to the plate. In the process, there was two wild pitches. As this is on the ground, up the middle, gloved at short, throw to first in time. So in the process of Haller at the plate, it was two wild pitches that pushed Thurber up to third, and then the sacrifice ground out by Haller drove in the first Ashland run. Nick Porter then came up, hit a single. Nick Burns would then fly out, no advancement by the runners. But then Trevor Gustafson would reach after a strikeout on a pass ball, followed by Mike Messier doing the same exact thing as there's a swinging strike. And then a ground out by Keim would make it so Ashland left the bases loaded after the first. So that's fouled away, and it was certainly very fortunate for Bill Ricca after two straight runners struck out and reached on a pass ball. 0-2 on Wolf. Burek is set to deliver. There's strike three. Two away, and now Brendan Thurber to the plate. Burek shakes off the first sign and now deals. Fouled away. Burek set to deliver. On the ground, up the middle, looks like it went off the glove of Burek, picked up by the shortstop, throw to first in time. And they go down 1-2-3 in the second inning after a long top of the first, a long bottom of the first. It was a short top of the second, a short bottom of the second. We head to the third. It's 2-1, Bill Ricca. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by Golden Pond Assisted Living. Honoring resident choice, dignity, and independence, our health and wellness focus keeps residents active. Golden Pond, state-of-the-art senior housing and healthcare services. Visit them online at goldenpondassistedliving.com. We are ready for the top of the third inning. A 2-1 Billerica lead as Obid set to deliver, and that pitch is in there for a strike to Dylan Salk, the second baseman. Salk grounded out his first time up. The leg lift and the pitch. It's the 1-2 and 3 hitters for Billerica. That pitch down low, 1-1. Obid to the set. On the ground, up the middle, gloved by the shortstop. Throw to first, one away. Brendan O'Flaherty to the plate. Sun's starting to glare on more of the field now after some ominous-looking clouds were in the distance earlier. Obid to the set. Hit in the air to the left side in fair territory, and it's going to drop. Drops right in front of Mike Messier, the shortstop who tried to chase it down. That was a tough one to gauge. It looked like maybe for a little while it was going to blow foul. A single for O'Flaherty, and that'll bring up Anthony Nelson. Nelson scored one of two runs for Billerica in the first. For those of you just joining us, you're watching Ashland Legion Baseball on WACA-TV in Ashland and HCAM Television in Hopkinton as that one's fouled away. Connor Donovan on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. We are in the top half of the third inning. It's a 2-1 lead for Billerica over Post 77. Obid awaits the sign, runner leading off of first. Check in, runner slides back, safe. Obid to the set. Third base side, foul. And two. Runner on first, one out. Obid set to deal. Down low, nice save behind the plate by Porter. So you can hear the wind blowing a little bit more. Wind up and the pitch, and that is foul. From the stretch. This hitter, I tell you, loves hitting them towards us. And he will hit this one once again to the left side, and it'll fall into the glove of Holler. Quick throw in, prevents any advancement from the runner. Two-way. That'll bring up Justin Burek. Checking at first, runner back safe. And this is clubbed to the left side. That'll drop in a shallow left field, and that's going to be a single. First and second, two outs, David Lindsay to the plate. Billerica hitters love to pull the ball. Lefty steps in. Just low. Leg lift and the pitch. Foul, third base side. A one and one count. And this is hit into left field. That'll drop down. Runner being waved around. The throw in, not in time, and another Bill Ricca run scores. An RBI single for Lindsay. As Brendan O'Flaherty comes around, Justin Burek moves up to second, and Craig Rich to the plate. Rich grounded out his last time up. In the first, that one's low. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. One and one. To the set. Hit in the air, a high fly ball towards right field, and it's handled. Kime makes the catch, and that will retire the side, but not before another Bill Ricca run scores. It's 3-1 heading to the bottom of the third. Bottom of the third inning, due up for Ashland are the second, third, and fourth hitters. Greg Haller will step in to face Justin Burek for his third inning of work. Haller hit a sacrifice RBI in the first inning. It was a ground out to drive in Thurber. And on that pitch, he will take it low, 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. And he will hit this in the air to right field, and it drops into the glove of David Lindsay for the first out. Now Nick Porter will come to the plate. He had a single in the first inning his last time up. Wind up and the pitch to Porter. There's a strike. 0-1. Burek to the set. Down low. A 1-1 count. Burek deals. Couple hops on the left side, gloved by the third baseman, throw to first in time. Two-way. Nick Burns to the plate, flew out his last time up. Lefty steps in. And he will hit this one in the air to the left side, and that'll drop foul. I have to say, I'm liking the bat Nick Burns is using. Nice green color to it. That one was just foul. That was close. There's not lines in the outfield, so you really wonder how close it was. There's strike two. Obviously, the umpire has a much better view down the line. Certainly not as close as us, but that one was very close. That one's filed away as Burns stays alive. 0-2 remains the count. Wind up and the pitch. And he gets a good piece of this, and what a catch by the second baseman. Dylan Saul coming to a dive for the catch, and that is the third out of the inning. We will head to the top half of the fourth. It's a 3-1 Billerica lead. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by WPC Pest Control. Don't tolerate, eliminate your pest problem. A family-owned business. You can call them at 508-366-1820 or find them online at WPCPest.com. Top half of the fourth inning, 7, 8, and 9 hitters due up for Billerica as the first pitch is down low, 0-1. Jake Obit out there for his fourth inning of work. David Applebaum at the plate. And that pitch will turn away the hitter inside, 1-1. Getting loose for post 77 is Alex Cohen. Just in case Obid runs into any trouble, the leg lift and the pitch down low. Obid to the set, and there's ball four. Four straight balls on the hitter. I'll bring up Matt Franchi, the left fielder. Wind up and the pitch. There's a strike. Obid from the stretch. Runner on first after a walk. On the ground, up the middle. Nice glove by Obid. Throw to second for one. Throw to first. They got him. Beauty of a double play. That was 1-4-3 on the double play. Bring up Jake Nelson, the catcher. Obid set to deal. Hit in the air to left field, and that'll drop fair and roll all the way to the wall. The chase down and the throw in, cut off by Messier. Runner slides into second with the double. Dylan Salk will come to the plate. Dylan Salk 0 for 2 today with a pair of ground outs. Had a tremendous play at second base defensively in the bottom of the third to end the inning. Hence, you can see the dirty jersey from that play. Obid set to deal. Down low. Obid from the stretch. And that's foul. 1-1. Obid takes a look at second. And now deals. Down low. 2-1. Wind up and the pitch. Slow roller on the infield grass up the left side. Throw to first. Bounces off the turf, but will end up in the glove of Nick Burns in time for the final out of the inning. Despite a big double from Jake Nelson, no runs score. And we will head to the bottom of the fourth. 3-1 Billerica. Bottom of the fourth inning, 5, 6, and 7 due up for Ashland post 77 as they look to get something going offensively. Trevor Gustafson, Mike Messier, and Andrew Keim coming to the plate to faced Justin Durek in his fourth inning of work. Has pitched pretty solid since the first inning. The leg lift and the pitch. Down low. Has had two straight 1-2-3 innings in the second and the third. Looking for another one here. Wind up and the pitch. Up the left side, couple hops. Gloved by the shortstop, throw to first in time. A 6-3 ground out to start things off for Gustafson, and now Mike Messier to the plate. Burek set the deal, just upstairs. Burek to the set, that's hit in the air, foul, and it is out of the reach of anyone. Anthony Nelson, the first baseman, and David Lindsay, the right fielder, came running over. Messier steps back in with the count 1-1. Burek to the set. Down low. Two and one. There's strike two. Grab the outer corner on the change. Burek to the set. Messier got a piece of that one, but it ended up in the glove of Jake Nelson, two away. Now Andrew Keim will come to the plate. Burek deals. Keim crushes this into right field. That drops down for a hit. An absolute rope. Rounding first, it'll roll all the way back to the wall. Keim will stop at second with the stand-up double. Now he's going to go to third as the throw got by the cutoff man. Throw to third is going to get away, and Keim's going to come around to score. So Keim had the double as it got past the cutoff man, and then ended up at third, and then on the overthrow, came home. And a well-needed run and some momentum for post 77. As J.J. Krupe will step in. The leg lift and the pitch inside. So I believe that error was on the shortstop. And this takes a couple hops and will hop into the glove of Burek, who will run it over to first, have the little flip, and it's a 1-3 for the final out. But post 77 does play to run. It's 3-2 as we head to the fifth. Top half of the fifth inning, it's now a 3-2 Bill Ricca lead as Obid set to deliver. And this is clubbed in the air to center field. Will fall into the glove of Brendan Thurber. One pitch, one out. Now Anthony Nelson will come to the plate. Obid still in the game, and we'll tell you how post 77 plated their run last inning. It was Andrew Keim hitting a double. And then the throw in got by the cutoff man, allowing him to go to third. As this is hit in the air, a little liner, and it's just over the reach of Messier in a left field, and there's a single for Nelson. Messier almost had a heck of a catch there, but just over his reach. And then a throw to third, though, to try to get Keim. Got by third base, allowing Keim to score. Obid from the stretch, one on, one out. Burek at the plate. That one is just low, 1-0. Runner leading. Down low, 2-0. And I have to imagine the leash with Obid is not too long right now. They do have Cohen ready to go. And this is a slicer in a center field. That'll drop down. And Thurber on the throw in. Runner advancing to third, threw it right to third. A beauty of a throw from Thurber, but Nelson is just able to reach third. And you can credit Burek with the single. Reach second on the throw in. Two on, one out. David Lindsay will come to the plate. And now head coach Derek Johnson's going to come out, and I think he's going to take the ball. And he indeed will take the ball. That will be it for Obid. A pretty good start, but ran into some trouble here in the fifth, and we will have a pitching change. We'll get you more details in just a bit. Alex Cohan, the new pitcher at Hopkinton High School. Graduated this year, will attend South Carolina University next year, comes in for Jake Obid. Obid went 4 1/3, giving up 10 hits, 3 runs, 1 walk. Cohen working from the stretch, 2 on, 1 out. The windup and the pitch. On the ground, third base side, and it's past the dive of Krupe and Messier. One run in. The throw in is going to be in time to get the second runner. A well-needed good defensive play by Greg Holler. So Anthony Nelson scores on the RBI single by David Lindsay. Burek was thrown out at the plate. So you could charge a fourth run to Obid. As the next hitter, Craig Rich is in. And this is right back to the mound. Cohan gloves it, throw to first, and there is the final out of the fifth inning. So Bill Ricca does tack on a run, and it is 4-2 as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Bill Ricca leading Ashland. Bottom of the fifth inning, a new pitcher for Bill Ricca. As moving in from left field was Matt Franchi to take over on the mound. Justin Burek swaps positions and moves down to left field. Matt Franchi, a lefty out of Lowell Catholic High School, graduated this year and will face Brendan Wolf as his first hitter. Wind up and the pitch, and Wolf will pull back the bunt, strike one. Burek had a pretty good start. A little surprising to see him get pulled. Franchi deals. Slow roller up the middle, glove by the second baseman, throw to first, one away. A 4-3 to start things off. Justin Burek went 4 innings, giving up 2 hits, 2 runs. One of those runs was earned. No walks, 1 hit batter, and 4 strikeouts. As Brendan Thurber comes to the plate. Franchi set to deliver. Down low, 1-0. Thurber has had a nice game. Got hit by a pitch and scored a run in the first. Ended up advancing to second and third on a wild pitch, and then came home to score on a RBI ground out as this is hit in the air to left field towards the wall, and the catch is made by Justin Burek, 2 away. Greg Holler to the plate. has a sacrifice RBI today, and he flew out. The leg lift and the pitch. Fouled away, 0-1. Nick Porter to hit, Shell Haller reach. Franchi with the leg lift and the pitch. Couple hops left side, gloved at short, throw to first, and it's an overthrow. Haller will reach and get the free pass to second. So Haller reaches and an error. Routine ground ball there. Nick Porter will come up. Two outs, runner in scoring position. A 4-2 lead for Billerica over Ashland. This is Ashland Legion Baseball on WACA-TV in Ashland and HCAM Television in Hopkinton. Burek delivers. There's a strike. Connor Donovan on camera, Tom Nappy on the call. It's been a pretty wild game here today, a little bit of everything. Burek from the stretch. Runner leading off of second. Delivers up high. Looks like that pitch had a pretty good slide to it. 1-1. Franchi to the set. And this is up the middle, gloved by the shortstop, throw to first. And that will be the third out of the inning. Porter goes 6-3, and that will retire the side. We head to the top of the sixth, a 4-2 Billerica lead. HCAM Sports is supported by our viewers and by dentists at Hopkinton, located at 77 Main Street, providing comprehensive dental care for clients of all ages, from childhood through adult, in a comfortable and relaxed setting. Find them online at hopdent.com. Also brought to you in part by Angels Garden Center, located at 65 School Street, growing in Hopkinton since 1957. Bedding, container plants, vegetables, culinary herbs, bark, mulch, firewood, and more. Visit them online at angelsgardencenter.com. As we are set for the sixth inning, due up for Billerica is 7, 8, and 9. David Applebaum, Matt Franchi, and Jake Nelson to face Alex Cohan in his second inning of work. Gets the sign he likes and deals inside, 1-0. Wind up and the pitch. That's just inside, a 2-0 count. To the set, down low. Wind up and the pitch. And there's a strike, 3-1. To the set, fouled away, and the count is full, ruled foul. Applebaum 0-for-1 today with a walk. Cohan with leg lift and the pitch, and this is on the ground, up the middle, gloved at short, throw to first, one away. We'll bring up Matt Franchi. Franchi started the day in left field and moved over to take over on the mound. Stays in the lineup at the same place. Cohan to the set. This is tapped into left field. That drops in for a single. Jake Nelson now to the plate. Runner leading off of first, Cohan from the stretch. There's a strike, 0-1. Pitch down low. From the stretch. And he delivers up high, checking at first, runner back safe. Good throw down the line by Porter. Cohan gets the sign and deals. That's fouled away. 2-2. Cohan set to deliver. And a liner up the middle, and it's going to get through the glove of Wolf. Wolf was on the infield grass in the center field, and that's another single. First and second with one out for Dylan Salk. Salk 0 for 3 so far. Cohan deals down low. Cohan looks at the leading runners and delivers 2-0. Cohan will check in at first, and the runner is ruled back safe. The Ashland infield did not agree. Pretty good pickoff attempt, however. It did look very close. Cohan deals. There's a strike. 2-1. As the wind starts to pick up here at Ashland Middle School. Windy, cloudy evening it's turned into. Upstairs, good save by Porter. One ball away from loading the bases. Fouled away, full count. Cohan set to deliver. And this is a high fly ball in foul territory. Burns trying to chase it down, and he will. Runners will hold up. Nice job by Burns chasing that one down. Brandon O'Flaherty, the shortstop, to the plate. Two away, two on. We do have action in the Ashland warm-up area. Pitch to the lefty is up high. Jeff Haller getting loose. Wind up and the pitch down low. Runners will hold as Porter blocks it. Cohan set to deliver. Upstairs, Porter will throw to second, and it is Not going to be in time. Messier was there to keep it from going into the outfield. 3-0. And there's ball four. Bases loaded now for Anthony Nelson, who's 2 for 3 on the day. Has also scored 2 runs. Scored in the first on the 2 RBI single by Justin Burick. And scored in the fifth on an RBI single by David Lindsay. Has a big opportunity here to break this game open. Cohan set to deliver. Swinging strike, a hard swing, 0-1. And Porter needs a breath after he took that one in the chest pad. A little timeout as Cohan ties his shoe and Porter takes a breath, and we are set to go. Nelson steps back in and awaits the pitch. 0-1 the count. Cohan from the stretch. Swinging strike. 0-2. Cohan set to deliver. And this is up the middle, and it is in the glove of Messier. Throw to first. Not in time, and a run scores. Franchi comes around on the RBI single by Nelson. Now Justin Burick will come to the plate. Now a 5-2 lead for Bill Ricca. Wind up and the pitch, swinging strike. Bases loaded, 2 outs. Cohan set to deal. There's strike 2. Cohan awaits the sign. Just outside. Burick is having a nice day as well. He's 3 for 3 at the plate at a 2 RBI single in the first. Has hit all singles. Fouls that one away. One and two. Cohan gets the sign. Swinging strike. And that will do it for the top half of the sixth, but not before Bill Ricca plates another run. They lead it 5-2 as we head to the bottom of the fifth. Bottom of the sixth inning, Nick Burns, Trevor Gustafson, Mike Messier due up to the plate, 4, 5, and 6. To face Matt Franchi in his second inning of work. Bill Ricca did pick up an extra run in the top half. So Post 77 has some work to do. As that pitch is just low. A 1-0 count. The leg lift and the pitch. There's a strike. One and one. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike two. Nick Burns 0 for 2 so far on the day. Got robbed in the third. A great play made by the second baseman on a liner. This is hit in the air, and it is in fair territory on the left side. And stepping in to make the catch was shortstop Brendan O'Flaherty for the first out. One away, and now Trevor Gustafson, the DH, to the plate. Wind up and the pitch. Just high. Franchi set the deal. Hit in the air, left side, foul. 1-1. Franchi to the set. Swinging strike, 1-2. Messier due up on deck. Wind up and the pitch to Gustafson. There's strike three. Ball briefly got away. Throw to first, not a problem. Mike Messier to the plate. Messier reached on a pass ball after a strikeout and has struck out so far today. Franchi delivers. Swinging strike. Oh and one. Leg lift and the pitch. And that is hit high in the air, foul territory, and out of play. 0-2. Wind up and the pitch. Swinging strike. And that will do it for the bottom of the sixth. Matt Franchi gets two straight strikeouts. Post 77 down to their final three outs, trailing 5-2 as we head to the seventh. Top of the seventh inning. Billerica trying to add some insurance as they lead Ashland 5-2. As Cohan remains in the game. First pitch, a swinging strike. By David Lindsay, the right fielder. He's reached on a fielder's choice and hit a pair of singles today. Had an RBI on both singles. Cohan to the set, to the lefty, and that pitch is just high. 1-1. Cohan set to deliver. Upstairs, 2-1. All post 77 can do now is get through this inning, hopefully without giving up a run, and see if you can get the bats going in the seventh. Bunt pulled back, strike two. Not in time. Two and two on Lindsay. The leg lift and the pitch. Swinging strike, one away. Craig Rich will come to the plate. Rich 0 for 3 today. And this is left side, fair territory. Throw to first, a little high, but Burns will pull down the J.J. Krupe throw for the second out. A 5-3, and now David Applebaum to the plate. Cohan delivers down low. One and oh. To the set. And that is hit in the air, foul territory, out of play. 1-1. Cohan set to deal. Down low. On the 2-1. Another low ball, 3-1 the count. And there's ball four. Applebaum draws the walk. Matt Franchi to the plate. There's a strike. Runner leading off of first. Down low, 1-1. Cohan deals, fouled away, 1-2. Cohan from the stretch. And this is in fair territory up the middle. Cohan bobbles it and has no play. Franchi reaches on the error. Applebaum advances a second. Jake Nelson, the catcher, to the plate with two outs, two on. Cohan deals. Down low. Nice block by Porter. Wind up and the pitch. Down low. Cohan delivers, and a nice block by Porter behind the plate, but that's three straight balls. Running into a little bit of a two-out jam here. This is hit in the air towards center field, and it is caught by Thurber for the third and final out. Post 77 down to their final three outs as they trail 5-2. Bottom of the seventh, post 77 down to their final three outs. Due up is 7, 8, and 9 in the batting order. Andrew Keim, J.J. Krupe, and Brendan Wolf to face Matt Franchi, who is in for his third inning of work, and he has been impressive thus far. As Keim is set for the pitch, and he will dab at the first pitch for strike one. Tingsboro, look, excuse me, Billerica looking for their second win of the season. There's strike two. Franchi set the deal. Swinging strike, one away. J.J. Krupe will step in. 0-2 so far today. Leg lift and the pitch. Down low, 1-0. Franchi deals. Check swing, couldn't hold, strike one. Franchi awaits the sign. Upstairs, 2-1. Franchi to the set. 3-1. Leg lift and the pitch. Ball four, runner on, four post 77. Brendan Wolf steps in, 0-2 on the day. Tying run on deck. Franchi deals, fouled away, 0-1. Matt Franchi takes a look at first and delivers. That is just outside, 1-1. Wind up and the pitch, checking at first, runner back safe. Franchi delivers up high, 2-1. This game not over yet. You got the top of the order coming up next for post 77, as long as a double play type of situation doesn't happen. And that is fouled away, 2-2. Runner started to take off there. Franchi set to deliver. And this is a half swing, but it'll be caught by the second baseman. It looked like maybe he was going to drop in that gap. A nice job by Salk getting to it, two away. I'll bring up Brendan Thurber. Thurber 0-2 today, was hit by a pitch and scored a run in the first. Billerica one out away from their second win of the season. There's a strike, beauty of a breaking pitch. Runner leading off of first, Franchi to the set. Checking at first, runner back. Wind up and the pitch. There's strike two. Post 77 down to their final strike. Leg lift and the pitch. Down low, one and two. Franchi awaits the sign. High fly ball into shallow center field, backtracking to make the catch is the shortstop, Brandon O'Flaherty. And that will do it for the ball game as Post 77 will fall once again. And today they fall 5-2 against Bill Ricca. We'll come back in just a moment and wrap things up here from Ashland Middle School. Well, another tough loss for Ashland Post 77 as they fall to 3-7 on the season. Tom Nappy here to wrap this game up. Bill Ricca improving to 2-6. A well-needed win for Bill Ricca to stay in any type of contention. Ashland Post 77, though, some tough luck here today. And really, it was just a matter of getting outpitched. A great pitching performance by Bill Ricca today. And it was really a mixed effort between Justin Burek and Matt Franchi, who both did a terrific job from the mound. Let's get to the recap. In the first inning, it was Bill Ricca who started things off as they planted two runs in the top half of the first. Dylan Salk started things off with the ground out. Brendan O'Flaherty then hit a double. Anthony Nelson would then hit a double. O'Flaherty only reached third. Burek then hit a two RBI single to drive in both O'Flaherty and Nelson. And then Lindsay reached on a fielder's choice, but then flyout by Craig Rich. Two runs in the inning for Bill Ricca. Post 77 responded on the bottom of the first. Brendan Thurber reached after being hit by a pitch. Greg Haller then had a sacrifice RBI to drive him in. And a wild situation in the first inning. Two Post 77 hitters reached after a strikeout on a pass ball, but they only got the one run that they scored early in the inning. So it was 2-1 until the top half of the third, in which Brendan O'Flaherty scored on an RBI single by David Lindsay, and then the next run would come in the bottom of the fourth. It would be a Post 77 run. Andrew Keim hit a double and then would reach third on an error on a ground out, and then would end up scoring on a misfire to the plate. He reached second on the double, and then an error allowed him to go to third, and then a error throwing to third allowed him to go home. So two errors on that play for Bill Ricca allowed Keim to score. At that point, it was a 3-2 game, and it would stay 3-2 until the top of the fifth, in which Bill Ricca would play another run. An RBI single by David Lindsay drives in Anthony Nelson, and then another Bill Ricca run came in the sixth as Matt Franchi scored on an RBI single by Anthony Nelson. So Bill Ricca getting the best of Ashland here today. They score five runs on 14 hits. Bill Ricca's defense, a little bit sloppy. They committed five errors. Keep in mind, two of them are from the pair of pass balls after the strikeouts. So the field really only responsible for three. Ashland, they scored two runs on two hits and committed two errors. A tough loss to take for Post 77. Keep in mind, they're a young team. They're developing, they're on the uprise, but for Bill Ricca to come in here, really only 10 players deep on their roster at 1-6 to beat you on your home turf, certainly a tough loss to swallow, but Ashland will get up from this and move on as they will play the very next day, and they will hope for a turnaround after a tough loss here today. Let's take a look at the pitching lines. We'll start off with Post 77. Jake Obid got the start, went 4 1/3, gave up 10 hits, 4 runs, Had one walk, no strikeouts. Alex Cohan provided solid relief, going 2 2/3, giving up 4 hits, 1 run, 2 walks, had 2 strikeouts. The starter for Bill Ricca was Justin Burek, and he had a great day. 4 innings pitched, 2 hits, 2 runs, only one of them earned. 1 hit batter and 4 strikeouts. Matt Franchi was terrific in relief. 3 innings pitched, no runs, no hits, 1 walk, 2 strikeouts. Once again, the final score for the final time. Bill Ricca improves to 2-6 on the season. Ashland falls down to 3-7 as Bill Ricca defeats Ashland 5-2. That is going to wrap up coverage of Ashland Legion Baseball. For Connor Donovan on camera, I'm Tom Nappy. We thank you for joining us for Ashland Legion Baseball on HCAM in Hopkinton or WACA-TV in Ashland. Enjoy the rest of your day.